Hey coach, welcome back. The previous videos discussed quality of movement, how we coach children to move safely and effectively. This video discusses how the body works to supply energy to power these movements. This is important because to help children become capable of performing movements with more intensity or for longer periods of time, we need to think about how to develop their energy systems. Humans require energy to power their movements. The energy we use comes from the food that we eat and is stored in various forms in our bodies. When it is time to use our stored energy, it needs to be quickly converted into a usable form, a high energy molecule known as ATP or adenosine triphosphate. Now, how the body produces this ATP depends on the type of activity we're engaging in. We can categorize movement activities by intensity and by duration. This is a bit of a trade-off, okay? The higher the intensity of the activity, the shorter the duration it can be maintained for. The three main categories of activity are explosive efforts, high intensity efforts, and endurance efforts. Each different type of effort is primarily supported by a different metabolic pathway. Put simply, a metabolic pathway is a chain of chemical reactions that leads to the creation and use of ATP. We'll explain these pathways a little bit more now. The first activity type we will deal with is explosive efforts. These are all-out efforts where children run as fast as they can, throw as far as they can, or jump as high as they can. Children will often naturally engage in these types of activities because they're fun. The energy system that supplies these types of activities is known as the phosphagen system. Energy from this energy system is instantly available, which is important if you need to avoid danger. But it's also depleted very quickly, usually within a few seconds. For this reason, explosive activities cannot be maintained for very long. The next activity type is high intensity efforts. These are sustained efforts where participants work as hard as they possibly can for durations of up to a minute. Examples of this type of activity include tug of war, long sprint races like the 200 and 400 meters, and short swimming races. The energy system that supplies these types of activities is known as the glycolytic system. This system is relatively inefficient and it generates a number of waste products that need to be removed from the working muscles. As a result, these types of activities often feel rather uncomfortable and they can result in burning in the muscles. In free play settings, children often don't typically engage in these types of efforts. They are more likely to alternate between high intensity explosive efforts and much lower intensity recovery bouts. The final activity type is endurance efforts. The energy system that supports these efforts is known as the oxidative energy system. It is called this because it relies on oxygen to break down energy stores to supply ATP. This is why we breathe harder when we exercise. We are supplying oxygen to our working muscles. This energy system is a little slow to respond when activity starts, but once it's activated, it is extremely efficient and supplies energy for very long periods of time. This is the predominant energy system whenever activities last for longer than a minute in duration, which honestly is most of the time. It is important to note that all three energy systems work together to supply energy for activities. All of the energy systems are active at all times, but they make bigger or smaller contributions to the energy supply based on the type of activity that is being performed. This is why children can still sprint or jump even after hours of playing. Now that we know what the energy systems are, it's time to give some thought to how we should train children to improve these energy systems. This is what most coaches might refer to as fitness. In short, the more well-developed your energy systems are, the more exercise you can do. When aiming to train energy systems, the mode of training should align with the energy system you want to develop. If you want to develop the ability to perform explosive efforts, training should involve very explosive efforts that last a few seconds in duration with lots of rest in between. To develop the endurance system, work intervals should be a few minutes in duration. A number of methods have been shown to be effective in developing energy system capabilities in children. These include 1. Long steady distance or LSD training. This is about doing continuous exercise bouts that last up to 20 minutes. 2. Endurance intervals, which entail work bouts lasting between 90 seconds and 4 minutes with similar rest periods. 3. High intensity intervals, which comprise of 10 to 30 second work bouts with rest periods that are at least twice as long as the work bout. 4. Repeat sprint or agility type activities that last up to about 5 seconds long with long recoveries in between the bouts. And 5. Game-based training, like small-sided games, for total durations of 20 minutes or more. If you like, this duration can be accumulated using different types of games. All of these methods have been shown by research to be effective for developing energy systems in children. Despite this, there are a few things we need to keep in mind when training children. 1. Training to exhaustion should be avoided. Children have smaller energy stores than adults, and as a result, they fatigue much faster. Our training volumes must reflect this. In order to avoid this, please allow children to self-select the training intensity and the rest period durations wherever possible. 2. Variety in training. Children need to develop a broad range of neuromuscular abilities for sport. Repeating the same type of activity in very high volumes increases the risk of overuse injury. For this reason, we recommend that a variety of different conditioning activities should be used. 3. Game-based activities offer a holistic solution where sport-specific technical and tactical skills can be improved at the same time as energy systems. These activities are naturally enjoyable and provide children the opportunity to self-regulate their exercise intensity. As a result, these should be a key part of any youth training program. Thanks for watching. We hope we provided some helpful information to help you plan exciting training sessions for your athletes. Good luck and see you soon.